Today we're going to see how to determine latitude and longitude. Now, before you all go off on a tangent about why the heck would you want to do this in the first place, I mean, what the heck? I'm flying a G-1000 equipped airplane that even brews fresh coffee and makes tasty bagels for me, if you know what I mean. You need to keep in mind that many student pilots are probably flying in something with a cockpit that looks like this. And although it might cook bagels when one of the two old radios blows up, it surely won't display latitude and longitude at the touch of a button. Second, if you are a student pilot, sooner or later you will need to tackle the infamous written test. And there are about 12 questions that deal with latitude and longitude. And I don't recall seeing any G-1000s readily available while you're taking the test. And by the way, take a good look at the new FAA testing booklet. If your study material still has black and white figures, you might be out of luck when you take the test, as all the questions have now changed to reflect the changes in the test supplement book. Make sure you have the current testing booklet or software. It's in color now. All the figures are in color. And if you don't like what you have been studying from, head over to passfaexams.com and take a look at our free demos to see how we make test taking fun. In any case, let's get on with it and see how to accomplish this task, and then take an actual test question from the Private Pilot Knowledge Test and see how to solve it.
A geographic coordinate system is a coordinate system that enables every location on Earth to be specified by a set of numbers. The choice is usually a number to specify elevation, so a vertical condition, and two or three numbers to specify a horizontal position. And the common choice of coordinates is latitude, longitude, and elevation. In geography, the latitude of a location on Earth is the angular distance of that location north or south of the equator. The latitude is an angle and is usually measured in degrees, minutes, and seconds. The equator has a latitude of 0 degrees, the North Pole has a latitude of 90 degrees north, and the South Pole has a latitude of 90 degrees south. Longitude is the angular distance of a point's meridian from the prime meridian, which is the Greenwich meridian, that passes through England. It is also expressed in degrees calculated east or west of Greenwich. If you're 10 degrees west of Greenwich, it will be 10 degrees west. If you're 10 degrees east of Greenwich, the longitude will be 10 degrees east.
There are plenty of questions on the test that ask you to calculate the latitude and longitude of an airport or a city or something else. So how do we accomplish this task? Well, the first thing we need to do is identify the initial longitudes and latitudes from the given figure. For example, from this figure here, we can find a latitude of 33 degrees, shown on the bottom center of the figure, and a longitude of 96 degrees, seen from the bottom left corner. The second thing you need to do is realize that the latitude and longitude are calculated in degrees, minutes, and seconds. Therefore, you would not be able to see a latitude of 33.75. That number would become 33 degrees and 45 minutes. 45 minutes is 3/4 of an hour, like 75 is 3/4 of 100. 33 degrees and 60 minutes is 34 degrees, as 60 minutes is a full degree. Next, remember that the 0 degrees longitude is over England. So in the US, and all the charts in the test are obviously from the US, on the west side you will find bigger numbers, and as you go east, they decrease in value. So in this chart, as we go east from 96, the first longer line we would find is 95 degrees and 50 minutes. Also, on VFR charts, each quadrant line represents half a degree, so the next vertical quadrant line is going to be 95 degrees and 30 minutes rather than 95 degrees. The longitude starts from 0 degrees at the equator and gets to 90 degrees at the poles. So as you go north, the number keeps increasing in value. Therefore, the first longer line, north of 33, will be 33 degrees and 10 minutes, and the first quadrant line will be 33 degrees and 30 minutes. Now, let's tackle an actual test question to learn this concept more thoroughly. This question says, refer to Figure 22, Area 2. What is the approximate latitude and longitude of Garrison Airport? And those are your three answers. First, we try to find the latitude and longitude numbers somewhere on the chart. I can see them one next to the other, both on the upper right corner. The latitude is 48 degrees, and the longitude is 101 degrees. Now, we can tackle this question in two ways. We can either go by elimination, or try to actually find the correct answer. But the best way to answer these questions, time permitting, is to use both methods so to be as precise as possible. Many students fail these questions just because they go too fast and make dumb mistakes. You don't want to do that. First, let's eliminate, and then confirm the correct one. As I said on the last slide, the longitude numbers will increase as we head towards the west. And because the Garrison Airport is west of the displayed longitude line, the longitude number needs to be greater than 101. This eliminates answer C. For the latitude, as we go towards the south, the equator, the longitude number will decrease. This means that the longitude of Garrison Airport needs to be smaller than 48 degrees. And this eliminates answer A. Now let's be precise and check that answer B is correct. Instead of checking the coordinates of Garrison Airport, let's draw out the coordinates given by answer B. We know the longitude line close to the bottom is 47 degrees and 30 minutes. So let's go up from there 9 minutes and 30 seconds and draw a line across. Next, we know that the longitude line left of the 101 line is going to be 101 and 30 minutes. So we will count 4 segments to the right of it and draw a line to meet the first line we drew. There you go. This confirms that answer B was the correct answer. And the coordinates of Garrison Airport are indeed latitude 47 degrees, 39 minutes, and 30 seconds north, and its longitude is 101 degrees, 26 minutes, and 0 seconds west. Well, as usual, all of us at Pilot Training Solutions hope you enjoyed this video, and hope it will help you ace those nifty questions on latitude and longitude that you'll find on the written test. And remember that our full courses are just around the corner. Visit PassFAExams.com, take a test drive with our free demos, and see the difference we can make in helping you ace the knowledge test for yourself. Pilot Training Solutions, a shining star in the universe of aviation. Until next time, we wish you all happy flying and blue skies.